JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for September the 10th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all the other major currencies on Thursday and during the Asian session Friday. It lost the most ground versus GBP, CAD, NZD and AUD in that order, while it lost the least against the euro. Now, the weakening of the US dollar and the strengthening of the commodity-linked currencies suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, looking at the performance of the equity world, we see a rather mixed picture. You see that European indices traded mixed, with the FTSE 100 losing the most ground as British airline EasyJet tumbled 10.2% after it rejected the takeover approach from Wizz Air. Wall Street also traded in the red, perhaps after Fed Board Governor Michelle Bowman said that joined the growing number of policymakers supporting that they should start scaling back quantitative easing purchases later this year. That said, with no clear catalyst, market sentiment improved during the Asian session today, with Hong Kong's Hang Seng recording the largest gains. Now, yesterday, the main event, the main economic event may have been the ECB interest rate decision, but the market reaction was not proportional to the significance of the meeting. In any case, the bank indeed announced a moderately lower pace of PEPP purchases for the following quarter, but refrained from revealing the exact number. At the press conference following the decision, President Lagarde made it clear that this was not a tapering move rather than a recalibrating, and added that the day when PEPP is over, the job is not finished, and that when the time comes, they have all the other tools available. In our view, this is a hint that when PEPP is over, conditional upon the economic outlook, they could compensate by buying more. They could compensate by buying more through other schemes, like the asset purchase program, the current pace of which stands at 20 billion euros a month. In other words, it appeared to be a technical move rather than a clear tapering, and that's why euro traders may have refrained from increasing their long positions much. As for today, the highlight may be Canada's employment report for August. The unemployment rate is expected to have slid to 7.3% from 7.5%, while the net change in employment is forecast to show an acceleration to 100,000 jobs from 94,000. Yesterday, Bank of Canada Governor Tiff Macklem said that he and his colleagues are moving closer to a time when continuing to add stimulus through quantitative easing won't be necessary, remarks suggesting that he's willing to proceed with further tapering at the October gathering. Therefore, despite the previous soft data, a decent employment report may add to bets over an October action and could support the loonie. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK monthly GDP as well as the industrial and manufacturing production rates, all for July. GDP slowed to 0.1% from 1%, and although industrial production rebounded 1.2% month over month from minus 0.7%, manufacturing production stagnated after growing only 0.2% in June. Later in the day, we have the US PPIs for August, with both the headline and core year-over-year rates expected to climb even higher. As for the speakers, we will get to hear again from ECB President Christine Lagarde and from the ECB Executive Board Member Frank Elderson. We will look for any extra clues as to whether the ECB plans to indeed end its PEPP program in March and whether it could indeed add more stimulus through other schemes. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.